Phuket's Ao Yon Bay in the Cape Panwa on the southwest side of Phuket, held their open day last Sunday, the 30th of September. And despite the heavy rain, quite a few residents, members and visitors, both foreign and Thai, turned up to watch and join in an informal and fun program of small dinghy sailing, canoe racing, and especially international driving boat racing, being held for the first time ever in Phuket. We arrived as they were holding some short kayak or canoe races for several active kids, including Maxine, Lilo and Emma here, who didn't mind getting wet and splashed in the rain and sea.
I'm racing to the island. We have the island on the line. I don't know what it means. Yeah, but we must have been 5 years old, so yeah. That makes us busy.
We know what we think about the rain. We love a lot.
Oh, this is not a lot of rain. It's cold rain, but it really is warmer.
And what are you going to do some sailing?
I think about it.
What do you like to do?
Well, I think I'll just stick to canoeing.
During the rain break, Bill Smith, secretary of the club, explained some of the club's activities and so-called adoption of sailing dinghy scheme to attract more sponsors and provide a stable financial support for this new but long-established club. Then Mike Darnold, from sponsors Sailing Asia, showed the first two groups of willing oarsmen and women some tips on how to row or stick their oars in at the same time and living for the driving boats. Once they learned the basics, it was time to push their boats out and hit the water. We want to have a lot of experience with the flow and speed of these first timers. Together with the young drummers, keeping the beat in rhythm with the crew. One of the crews practiced the capsizing, so they were half an act in the emergency. After they pulled into shore, we spoke to oarsman and environmentalist Marco Reinhardt, who recently cycled and canoed all around Phuket, and to Mike about his first outing for the crews.
I thought today went very well considering the weather, and there's an enormous amount of effort put into that. All sorts of things, getting it together, keeping involved, possibly skills being learned, some skills being developed, and Marco for the first time this has been working with us. I think this is setting the pace, because you have to ask him about the quality of the event. You might have prepared yourself in training into it.
It's interesting. I'm looking forward to doing some racing. You know the basics, and once you have the basics, you just practice. And then after that, it's you do what you came to do, you know.
Mike was a teacher of China.
It's some people, you know, we all look at these very makes sense, you know, looking forward to working with them.
Mike is willing to train and help crews form for proper races at the Pinox Boat Show on Sunday, December the 9th.
Actually, we've got about another 10 weeks of practice down at Ao Yon. Saturday afternoon, Sunday morning, we're trying to put 25 to 50 teams out for climax for their boat show. And the last day of boat shows on Sunday, we're inviting a whole of the community to get involved, universities, schools, charities, businesses, everybody. We want everybody out there, and it's really
website on how to join the firm Dragon Boat teams, see www.phuketdragonboat.com or telephone Mike on 087-281-0458. While everyone was recharging their energy with a hearty barbecue and refreshments, we asked Kelly Brooks, sailing secretary, more about the club's regular sailing activities in the next few months.
We're hoping that the open day today and the really lot of exposure that we've had is going to bring a lot more members to the club and that we're going to have a lot more students training. It's a fantastic position sailing. All year round, we are charging a little bit later today, but we can, once the children have got the skills, we can take them to start sailing.
For more information on Phuket Yacht Club, please see the website www.phuketyachtclub.info or contact Happy on